Sorry, guys, I was a little late on a little slow on the draw there. I was just writing a few things down, you know, this crap in there's my head, and I got to put it down because I might think it might fly, but evidently, according to my ratings, oh, probably only 2% of my crap actually gets anywhere, and people probably might come back and listen. So, but anyways, I keep writing and stuff, and what I wrote down now, I found out that through some people here, well, not here, but... first off, this is Captain Boomer coming to you live from the Twin Cities area, undisclosed area, due to a witness protection program. I can't go any further than that. I can't divulge any more information about exactly how I got on the program, what it all involved, and where I am. So there you go. You just have to deal with my secrecy. And anyway, I checked on this. Oh, I got to get some better. I checked on... a couple of the podcasters, do's and don'ts and stuff. And what I found out was, and I'm not a bit surprised, I'm doing every freaking thing wrong. Everything possible that can go, that I could do wrong, I'm doing it. Oh yeah, my intro is shot, my volume is shot, my everything. Excuse me. So there you have it. So if it's any, I guess that's my defense. But but you know, here's the kicker. Here's the flip side. At my age, I don't give a shit. If you're gonna listen, you're gonna listen. Anyway, yeah, this show is entitled, believe it or not, 220 and counting. Really? 220 shows. Wow. Keeps me out of trouble, keeps me out of the buffet line, keeps me out of the bars. Of course, I haven't been in the bars in, oh, geez, almost 40 years. Yeah, I quit at, well, anytime quit drinking or drugs or anything is a good time. But it's just that kind of bummed me out because, man, they were coming out with different flavored, well, not beer kind of, but, man, they were coming out with all sorts of different stuff. I told the wife, I said, come on, honey, how about if I just quit 3 months, 6 months? I want to try some of this new stuff out. Yeah. God, I can't remember what the hell the name was. I quit drinking in 81, so whatever was in 81, fairly new. That's what I missed out on. But anyway, be that it is me. I'm proud of myself and everybody else who can kick, you know, go and get in for help and get your Al-Anon going and get to your, I don't even know if they have any AA meetings anymore. You hardly ever hear that phrase out there anymore, as you don't a lot of other kind of phrases. And here's one right now that I don't understand. Maybe you guys can figure it out and see if you were on the same page. All these hot temperatures that's going on right now, you know, plus the COVID. I mean, we got some really screwed up times, don't we? I mean, oh my God. Jesus, God. I tell you. Anyway, it's global warming. Not one mention of global warming on any news channel, news station, anywhere. The weather guy's right there, and he's got this huge map, you know, of the United States, and here all that great, the whole country's bright red. You think it's on fire. And from East Coast to the West Coast, it's temperatures in the 90s, in the 100s. And I'm thinking, wait a minute. There's got to be global warming involved here big time, right? Well, at least that's where it was a couple years ago. I mean, man, the temperatures, they'd say, yeah, it's global warming, But no word on global warming now. And this is probably one of the hottest summers, if not the hottest, that I can recall. Anyway, so there you go. National Boomers Day is coming up, gang. I don't know. I'll keep you posted on that. A National Boomers Day. Yes, I think it's long overdue. And we're going to have our own day set aside for us. And because we are a very special generation. Anyways, and that's kind of why I'm doing this, because I believe we are special. I believe the way things are going right now, we're probably one of the last, great. I'll use the word great. I don't care. People always say it was the greatest generation or whatever. I don't know. Anyway. At least when he come back and he won that war and everything, you know, unlike us Vietnam vets, you know, spit on. Oh yeah, one guy I read a deal on. A girl gave him a paper bag, and he was kind of excited or kind of he felt good about it because he was assuming that the young lady was giving him some cookies, some brownies. With the little green stuff in it, don't you know? You know what I mean. But no, it was a bag full of human feces. Yes, yes. Thank you very much. Yeah, we all want to get off an 8-hour flight, don't we? And have a bag of shit handed to us. And then he walked on further, probably, and he got spit on. And then down even further, he probably walked on, and guess what? Walked down there, and guess what? Yeah, they were calling them baby killers. Yeah, so don't tell me about this greatest generation shit. You know, maybe I'm angry, maybe I'm bitter, but I'm telling you, that's the reality of it. That's the reality of it. We were involved, us boomers, we were involved in a war that still today is unexplainable. It's weird. It's a lot of underlying factors there that the average grunt, we didn't know. We didn't know what the hell was really going on. But anyways, and then you get home and you get this shit, you know. Then you get to hear and see all the bullshit back home, you know, about we don't belong there, you guys suck. And then we got to listen to Hanoi Hannah and that bitch. Fuck. Go home, you have no business here. This is not your war. You cannot win this war. We are dug in really deep in our trench. You will not find us. Yeah, you should go home. Yeah. Wonderful. Hey, I got off on a little tear, right? It's tear time. You just, or it's, as I like to call it, the venting vet. Yes, and there's a lot of us out there. I just wish we could all get together and vent, you know. You got all these goddamn talk shows out there. What the hell is this? Some god, I just want to puke and get. I almost do puke. I think one is the View, and the other one is Let's Talk or whatever. It's just, you know, ay. Crazy world out there. You betcha. Anyway, I got to get this out there. You guys got to. Check into the Villages of Viagra, one of my sponsors here. The Villages of Viagra. Yes, it is. Check it out, guys. I mean, you're going to have one hell of a weekend. You check it out. Anyway, Villages of Viagra, their motto is, where a hard day is a good day. There you go. I mean, it doesn't get more... You know, that's pretty much explainable, whatever there. Anyways, there we go. Oh, well, anyways, I read everything that, you know, I told you I was reading stuff about podcasting. Yeah, I'm doing everything wrong, but then again, anyway, this is just a hobby, I'm telling you. As you probably can tell, right? You betcha. It's just a hobby, that's right. Yeehaw! To down the Texans down there. All you people down there, listen, I really did, and I'm very appreciative and moved by. I now have about 35 countries that I've actually infiltrated, and I don't know how, but yeah, 35 countries I've got now, and I've yet to get the continent itself. I got Egypt, but Egypt is of Africa. So if anybody's out there listening in the Congo, in Nigeria, in what is it, Tanzania, all those places, I'd really appreciate somebody. Yeah, another place is out there, Adak, Alaska. I was up there in 1970, in my military, during my military day years. So Adak, a big shout out to you guys. Beautiful but desolate. Yes, it is. I left Adak in 70, and I've seen pictures on Facebook and different things about it now. Yeah, I guess they had a McDonald's up there at one time, and I guess it didn't go over too good. And I don't think it lasted very long. But anyway, God bless you, Adak, Alaska. God bless you. Check in once in a while, will you? I would really enjoy that. I would really like that. Yes, indeed. Okay, anyways, what else we got to bullshit about? Oh, yeah, guys, don't forget. Pig Latin workshops around the Twin Cities. Well, because of COVID, they're shut down too. I'll keep you posted on that when they're planning on opening up, because I know a lot of you guys like to pick up on your and keep up on your Pig Latin. Ouye, arye, umde, ukrefe. So there you go. You guys, you ain't going to hear this stuff on anybody else's podcast. Uh-uh. No way. You, of all the podcasts in the world, you had to listen to mine. Play it again, Kev. Well, I will. I'll play it again. You damn right. All right. We're moving along, aren't we, guys? I don't know what we're going to listen to, but I'm going to be playing some music pretty soon. I know that much. Oh, whoa. Man, these guys are early. Well, there you go. They are early, aren't they? Here they... Whoa. Yes, low and outside. There they are. There they are. If you're a true blue boomer, you're going to know who this is. They are of Car 54, Where Are You fame, Officers Trudy and Muldoon. Yes, they are. They are the donut detectives. Yeah, I mean, they're hunting down the best deals in town. Right, guys?
Yeah, Captain.
Who's that, Trudy?
Yeah.
Are you guys... So, were you guys after Dale today?
No. We gave him up. They gave me the shits.
Okay, well... All right, Tootie got shits from day-old donuts. All right. Okay, you guys, take care. Love you. Huh? Later on, dudes. Keep us safe, baby. Wear those masks. There you go. Gotta love them. Car 54, where are you guys? If you guys remember them, I hope you do, because they were dynamite, as a lot of our stuff. I'm trying to get explain more of what the hell this all is all about in a way, and this is the way my son is helping me, because I am so challenged. I just wish somebody would get a hold of me and help me out a little bit here, because I don't know how many good years I got left. You know what I'm saying? Well. Agent Orange has got something to do with that. I knock on wood, my head. Yeah, I have been very, very lucky. I got some weird shit going on, but I can't 100% attribute it to Agent Orange, but although I did breathe the shit. But anyways, I'm going to have my little page out. It's called Boomer Gramps. And I don't know if you saw some of it, but I'm trying to fine-tune it, as I'm trying to fine-tune a lot of things on here. I got so many different things in the works that I just haven't went back and they finished. I got a lot. I got a